first of all, you need to know what is meant by a transmitter. A transmitter is a device which can be simply explained as a transducer plus a signal conditioner. So, in a process control loop, a transmitter is a very important thing which we are using to take the output of the sensor to a controller. So, the transmitter is a device which is mainly used for transmitting the signal from a sensor to a controller. And our controller is simply similar to a computer. So, it's not able to deal with all such variables. So, we are actually converting, this transmitter is actually converting the output from the sensor to a proportional signal. So, here we are going to discuss about a pneumatic transmitter. In case of the pneumatic transmitter, here you are able to see that it consists of this is the figure of a DP transmitter. Here we are giving the high pressure side and here we are giving the low pressure. And inside this one, here we are having a sealed capsule, and we all know that the capsule is a pressure measuring device or it's a pressure measuring sensor. And this is given to a this is sealed inside a force bar. And that force bar is connected to a flapper nozzle mechanism. And in case of a pneumatic transmitter, the major working principle of a pneumatic transmitter is called as a flapper nozzle mechanism. That is nothing but I will now itself I will explain that one. And that flapper nozzle is connected to an air supply or air relay circuit. Here, inside this air relay circuit, we are giving a 20 psi supply. That is nothing but the working supply of our pneumatic transmitter. That is a 20 psi working supply. And that 20 psi is already we are giving to the air relay. And just consider that in this high pressure side, our sensor reading is coming. And if the sensor reading is very low, means that flapper will be very, very much away from the nozzle system. And that means we are supplying a 20 psi working supply, and also there will be much leakage in the flapper and in between the flapper and the nozzle. So if there is so many leakage also, we are able to get a small amount of back pressure. That means 3 psi pressure inside our air relay. And if you are just consider that if you are giving the 100% output or the maximum output, means this capsule will be extended to this side, and this will directly act on the force bar, and that flapper will be coming near to the nozzle side, and that means the leakage in the flapper nozzle side will be very very less, or it will be very much reduced, and we are able to get a 15 psi output. So here we are giving a 0 to 100% output from the sensor section, and here we are taking it as the output in a 3 to 15 psi manner. Here we are giving the minimum to maximum sensor output, and we are taking a proportional 3 to 15 psi conditioned signal here. So this signal is able to understand by the controller, and this is what actually happening inside a pneumatic transmitter. And here we are able to see a feedback bellows, and in this bellow here we are having a screw. Here only we are able to do a zero calibration. Here we are having a feedback bellow, and just connected to this feedback bellow we are having a zero adjusting screw. So here only we are doing our zero calibration, and if you want to do our fan calibration, means we want to adjust this force bar. So this is what actually happening inside a pneumatic transmitter. And the output of an electronic transmitter will be 420 milliamps, and its working supply will be 24 volt AC, 110 volt AC, or 230 volt AC.